to power your facilities, we need structures that can provide us with that power. The easiest to build is the diesel power plant. So if we press B to open our build menu and we go to the power category, we can see that if we hover over the diesel power plant, that it will take 150 basic materials to make a diesel power plant. The diesel power plant will produce 5 megawatts of power for 45 seconds at the cost of 25 liters. If we keep calculating with that, it comes down to 20 jerry cans of diesel per hour, or 480 jerry cans of diesel in a 24-hour period. To make one, we need a construction vehicle or an advanced construction vehicle. So we check our construction vehicle to see if it has the necessary basic materials. It has. So we hop into the driver's seat. We drive it to a foundation. We press B to open the build menu again. We select the diesel power plant, and we can see that if it is not on a foundation, that it will tell us that it must be built on a foundation. So if we hover it over the foundation over here, we can see that if we place it correctly, it will turn yellow. The yellow is showing us that it is actually placeable right here. In the left side of the building, we see an input arrow. That input arrow points to where a pipeline can be connected to pump in diesel. On the right side of the building, we see the power connector. So we put it in an orientation we want by holding down the right mouse button and turning the orientation of the diesel power plant. When we are happy with it, we left click to place the blueprint, drive up our CV, and start hammering in the basic materials. When we are done building, we can press E to open the menu of the diesel power plant, and on the left side we can see the inventory of the diesel power plant, and in the bottom left side the inventory of ourselves. In the middle is a production panel where we can see that there is only one recipe available. In the bottom middle is the actions panel. We can reserve the diesel power plant for our active squad or for our squad. We can also do reserve multiple, and that will reserve all facilities that are connected through power lines. Reserving a power plant will prevent other players from upgrading the power plant and changing the recipe. We can also choose to demolish our diesel power plant. As we can see, we must be the original builder or be in the squad of the original builder. There must be no enemies nearby, and it must be done within 168 hours of construction. There is also the option to disconnect, and if we use that, we disconnect all power lines that are connected to this diesel power plant. We can flag it for disruptive placement, and we can open the structure event log, which tells us things like the recipe got changed, the building got built, or somebody supplied the building with fuel. In the top right is the stockpile of the diesel power plant. In the middle right, we see the status panel, which shows us whether or not we are producing power and how much power is being used. And we can see how much diesel is currently in the fuel tank of the diesel power plant. And in the bottom right is the upgrade panel, which we can use to upgrade the diesel power plant to either a petrol power plant or a coal power plant. As we can see in the status panel, currently we are not producing any power. For that, we need to have a diesel in the diesel power plant. So if we try to put a diesel in the inventory of the diesel power plant, we can see that we are still not producing any power. And that is because the diesel needs to go into the fuel tank of the diesel power plant. So to do that, we have to come out of our CV. So we press escape, we hop out. We walk up to the diesel power plant, we press E to open it, we grab the diesel jerry cans that were in the inventory of the diesel power plant, we press tab to get out of this menu, press tab again to get into our inventory, equip a jerry can of diesel, tab out, press 3 to equip the jerry can and aim at the diesel power plant and hold down the left mouse button. As we can see, we are refueling the fuel tank of the diesel power plant. And as soon as enough diesel was in, we could see that the diesel power plant turned on. If we now press E to open its menu, we can see that we are producing 5 megawatts and that we are using 0. In the status panel, we can also see that the fuel tank of the diesel power plant is only slightly filled. To stop producing power, we can simply go to the recipe that uses the diesel and click the switch that is behind it, and this will turn off the diesel power plant. If we start to fill up the diesel power plant some more, we can see that the maximum amount of diesel that can be in the diesel power plant's fuel tank is 1,000 liters. The diesel power plant can be upgraded, so if we come to the diesel power plant and we press E and we go to the bottom right, we can see that we have two possible upgrades. The first upgrade will upgrade the diesel power plant to petrol power plant. This will allow us to use 50 liters of petrol every 1.5 minutes to produce 12 megawatts of power. This comes down to 40 cans of petrol per hour, or 960 cans of petrol for a full day. To get the upgrade, we need 100 construction materials. So if we come to our truck over here and we grab 100 construction materials and we come back to our diesel power plant, we press E to open it. We shift click on the construction materials so it goes into the inventory of the diesel power plant. We can now left click on the petrol power plant upgrade icon and we will start modifying the structure. As soon as the structure is modified, we can see that the model changed, and if we press E to open its menu, we can see that we gained an extra recipe in the production panel. Also in the status panel, we see that we gained an extra fuel tank, and that fuel tank is for petrol. To refuel the petrol power plant, we need to do the same thing as with the diesel power plant. We equip the petrol and we aim at the petrol power plant, and if we hold down the left mouse button, we can see that we are putting it in the fuel tank for petrol. If we press E to open the menu again, we can see in the production panel that we have the choice between both these recipes. So we can either turn on the diesel recipe or we can turn on the petrol power plant. So if we try to turn on both and we click on the switch, we can see that it turns on the petrol power plant, but it will turn off the diesel power plant. As we can see, we are currently producing 12 megawatts of power. To turn it off, we can simply click the switch and that will turn off the petrol power plant. We come to the diesel power plant over here and we press E to open its menu and we go to the upgrade panel. We can see that the other upgrade is the coal power plant upgrade, and that will give us the possibility to burn 60 coal every 1.5 minutes to produce 5 megawatts of power. This will work out to 2,400 coal per hour or 57,600 coal per day. Because the stockpile can at maximum hold 32k coal, means that on a full stockpile, a coal power plant can run for 13 hours. The cost of a coal power plant upgrade is the same as the petrol power upgrade. It is 100 construction materials. So we walk to our truck, we grab 100 construction materials, walk up to the diesel power plant over here, press E to open its menu, shift click on the construction materials, which will put it in the inventory of the diesel power plant, and then in the upgrades panel, we click on the upgrade button for the coal power plant. We will start to modify the structure. As soon as we're done modifying the structure, we can see that the model changed. And now if we press E to open its menu, we can see that we got an extra recipe. So to make the coal power plant work, we need to put coal into the stockpile. So we come to our truck, we grab these stacks of coal and we walk up to the coal power plant, press E to open its menu, and we right click in our backpack on the coal and we select submit all to stockpile, and we can see that we now have 700 coal in the stockpile of the coal power plant. To turn on the coal power plant, we simply click on the switch behind the coal recipe, and as soon as we do that, we can see that the coal power plant took 60 coal from the stockpile and is now producing 5 megawatts of power for the next 1 minute and 30 seconds. To turn it off, just as with any other recipe, simply click the switch and that will turn off the recipe. Besides the diesel, coal, and petrol power plants, there is another option to produce power. It is the power station. So if we press B to open our build menu and we go to the power category, the last entry is the power station. If we hover over it, we can see that we will get 10 megawatts of power for 1 minute and 30 seconds for every 50 liters of crude oil, or 10 megawatts of power for 1 minute and 30 seconds for 30 coal and 1 liter of water. The cost of the building is 25 processed construction materials. So to make one, we need a construction vehicle or an advanced construction vehicle that has processed construction materials in it. We hop into the driver's seat. We press B to open the build menu, select a power station. And when we click on it, we get the blueprint underneath our mouse cursor. We can see that it is a very large blueprint. Over here, we can see the connection point for our power lines, and on the backside, we can see the pipe connection where we can pump in either crude oil or water. And if we are happy with the orientation, we can left-click. That will place the blueprint, drive up to it, and start hammering in the processed construction materials. Now the power station is ready. We now hop out of our CV and we come to the power station and we press E to open it. We can see that it basically shows the same menu as the diesel power station. So in the left side, we have our inventory and the inventory of the power station. In the middle is the production panel that has two recipes. In the middle bottom, we have the actions panel. On the top right, we have the stockpile of the power station where we can store coal, sulfur, and coal cokes. In the status panel, we can see how much power we are producing, how much water is in the power station, and how much crude oil is in the power station. In the bottom right, we can see the upgrades panel, and there is one upgrade available, and that is the sulfuric reactor upgrade. So to turn on the oil recipe, we obviously need oil in the oil tank of the power station. So over here, I have a fuel truck that has crude oil in it. So we come to the power station, we press E to open its menu, come to the status panel and simply click the refuel button. And as we can see, that throws out a hose from the fuel truck that has the crude oil in it into the power station. And if we open up the menu of the power station again, we can see that our oil tank is filling up. Now, if we click the switch behind the crude oil recipe, we can see that we start to provide 10 megawatts of power. Now, to use that other recipe, we need coal in the stockpile and water in the water tank. So we come to our truck over here that has coal in it and 2 cans of water. We drive our truck close to the power station till it says in the bottom left, press E to use power station. We press E to open it. And in the bottom left, we right click on the coal that is in our truck and select submit all to stockpile. That will put 1.3k coal in the stockpile of the power station. We then need to get water into the water tank. For that, we hop out of our truck real quick. We press E to open the truck, grab the 2 water cans into our backpack, press tab to open our inventory, select the water can so it goes into our 3rd slot, press 3 to equip it, walk up to the power station, and while we aim at the power station, hold down the left mouse button. As we can see, while we are refueling, it has a maximum capacity of 1,000 liters. So now that there is water in the water tank and coal in the stockpile, we can turn on the coal recipe. And if we click the switch, we can see that smoke is coming out of the stacks and that we are producing 10 megawatts of power. As said before, you can also pump in water or crude oil through the pipe connection in the back. The power station can be upgraded to have a sulfuric reactor, which will produce even more power and in the meantime also produce sulfur. So if we press E to open its menu and go to the upgrade panel in the bottom right, we hover over the sulfuric reactor, we can see that it will produce 16 megawatts of power by using 50 liters of heavy oil every 2 minutes and that will produce 5 sulfur. Or alternatively, there is another recipe that will require 30 coal cokes and 1 liter of water every 2 minutes to produce 16 megawatts of power and 5 sulfur. The cost to upgrade the power station to have a sulfuric reactor is 25 steel construction materials. As we can see in the inventory, we already have 10 steel construction materials in the inventory of the power station. Our truck has another 15, so we hop in the truck, press E to open the inventory of the power station and get the remaining 15 steel construction materials in the inventory of the power station. We hop out of the truck, open a power station again, because you cannot upgrade a structure from within a vehicle. We come to the upgrade panel, and to upgrade the power station, we simply have to left-click on the upgrade icon, and we can see that we are modifying the structure. As soon as the structure is modified, we can see that the model changes, and if we open its menu, we can see that we gained 2 extra recipes under Sulfuric Reactor. In the status panel, we can see that we gained an extra tank. That tank is for heavy oil. To refuel the sulfuric reactor, I have a fuel truck here that is filled with heavy oil. So we come to the power station with the sulfuric reactor upgrade, press E to open its menu. And in the status panel, we go to the heavy oil row and click on the refuel button. If we now escape out of this menu, we can see that a hose is pumping the heavy oil from the fuel truck into the power station. If we now open up the menu of the power station again, we can turn on the sulfuric reactor. And when we do that, we can see that we are using heavy oil and that we are producing 16 megawatts of power. And as a byproduct of the sulfuric reactor, we will also gain 5 sulfur, and that will be deposited in our stockpile. To use the other sulfuric reactor recipe, we can simply click on the switch behind the other recipe, and that will turn off the heavy oil recipe and turn on the coal coke and water recipe. As we can see, we do have water, but we don't have coal cokes in the stockpile, so we can remedy that by hopping into the truck over here that has coal cokes in it. We press E to open the power station again, and then right click on the coal cokes in our truck and select submit all to stockpile. As soon as the coal cokes came into the stockpile, we could see that the sulfuric reactor took out 30 coal cokes and started producing 16 megawatts of power. To run our facilities, we need to get the power from our diesel, coal, and petrol power plants to our facilities themselves. To do that, we can use power poles. So with our hammer out, if we press B to open the build menu and we go to the power category, we can see that there are power poles. Power poles need to be built with a hammer and require 20 basic materials. So we grab 20 basic materials real quick. We press B to open our build menu again, and if we select the power pole, we get the blueprint underneath our mouse cursor. We can left click to place the blueprint, walk up to it, and start hammering in the basic materials. Now to connect it to, we press B again and go into the build menu and we select a power line. And when we do that, we can see that it tries to snap to any power connector. So that can be the power connector on the facility, the power connector on the power pole, or the power connector on the diesel power plant. Now if we try to connect our diesel power plant straight to our facility, we can see that it gives an error message saying must connect to power. So we aim at the power pole and we left click, and that will connect the power line between the power pole and the diesel power plant. And we do the same thing from the power pole to the facility by left clicking on the power pole and connecting it there. And then when it connects to the facility, we left click to confirm. Now, if we come to the facility and press E to open the menu, in the status panel, we can see that we are not getting any power. And that is because our diesel power plant isn't on. So we come to our diesel power plant, press E to open it, and we turn on the diesel recipe that will start producing 5 megawatts of power. And if we come to our facility and we open it up, we can see that it is provided 2 megawatts of power. Now, if we come to the power pole and we are close to it till it says in the bottom left, press E to use power pole, we can open its menu. And in its menu, we can see in the status panel that it has currently 5 megawatts of power connected to the power pole and that it only has a drain of 2 megawatts. Now, if we also connect our metalworks factory to the power pole by pressing B and opening the build menu, in the power category, we select a power line, connect it to our power pole, and connect it to our metalworks. And if we now look at both our metalworks and our material factory, we can see that the lights turned off. And if we press E to open the metals factory, we can see in the status panel that we are not getting enough power to our materials factory. And if we do the same thing at our metalworks, press E to open it, in the status panel, we can see that we also don't have enough power going towards our metalworks factory. So the choice we have here is to either turn off metalworks factory and that will turn back on our materials factory, or if we turn off the materials factory, we can turn on the metalworks factory because our diesel power plant is providing us with 5 megawatts of power. When we look at the description of the power pole, we can see that it says up to 4 power lines can be attached to a single pole. What this means is that if we try to connect more than 4 power lines, that the power pole will refuse. So if we select the power line and we come to power pole here, connect this power pole to our diesel power plant over here as well, we can see that we now have 4 power lines connected to this power pole. We now try to connect this materials factory over here to this power pole as well. We can see that it says no connection points available. So one way to connect this material factory to this power pole is by disconnecting one of the other buildings. So to do that, we come, for instance, to this diesel power plant over here. We press E to open its menu, go to the actions panel, and we click disconnect all. And after we click disconnect all, we can see that the power line has been removed. And if we now press B and select a power line and connect our materials factory to the power pole over here, we can see that it turns yellow. And if we left click, that we get a line that connects the materials factory to this power pole. Another limitation of power grids is how many power poles you can be away from your source of power before you lose power. That number is currently 19 power poles. So if we come to the petrol power station over here and we turn on the petrol recipe so that we have power, if we check the first power pole, we can see that we have 12 megawatts of power. Now, if we follow our line along and we go to our 19th power pole over here, and we press E on it, we can see that we have 12 megawatts of power. However, if we move to the 20th power pole and we press E, we can see that it says 0 megawatts of power. That extension range is just to one side, so we can extend the range to another side. So if we want to, we can have 19 power poles going this way as well, extending from the power station. If we turn on our 3 petrol power plants that are all connected to the same power pole, so we come here and we turn on the petrol power plant over here, providing 12 megawatts of power. We turn on this one, providing another 12 megawatts, which is 24, and turn on this one, which is also producing 12 megawatts, we have 36 megawatts of power. However, if we come to the power pole over here and we press E to open its menu, we can see that we only have 30 megawatts, and that is because we reached the grid limit. Now, to counter this, we can make a separate grid for one of the petrol power plants. So we press B to open the build menu and we select a power pole. We hammer in another power pole. We come to the petrol power station, we come to the actions panel, disconnect it, and then press B to open the build menu, select a power line, and connect our power line to this power pole over here. And now we have 2 grids, the grids over here that's producing 12 megawatts of power, and this grid over here that's producing 24 megawatts of power. Anything over the grid maximum will just disappear and will not be usable. besides manually switching over recipe in a factory, for instance, this materials factory, and coming in and clicking on the switch behind the recipe to turn off the materials factory, there is another way of doing this. The other way of doing that is to use a power switch. With our hammer out, if we press a B to open our build menu and we go to the power category, we can see that a power switch exists. It will cost us 25 construction materials. When we click the power switch, we get the blueprint underneath our mouse cursor. If we are happy with the placement, we can left click. That will put the blueprint down. We can then walk up to it and start hammering in the construction materials. Now, instead of routing the power through this power pole over here, we come to the power pole. We press E to open its menu, and in the actions panel, we select a disconnect all. This will remove all the power lines that were connected to the power pole. We then press a B to open the build menu and select our power line, and we connect the power station to our power switch. Then we grab another power line and connect our power switch to our materials factory over here. We can see that the materials factory currently has a power because the lights are on, but if we come to the power switch, still it says press E to use power switch in the bottom left, we can press E and we come to the menu of the power switch, and there is a one switch that we can click. And if we click that, we can see that our power went from 10 megawatts to 0 megawatts, and if we escape out of the menu, we can see that the materials factory doesn't have any lights anymore. To turn it back on, obviously, we press E to open the power switch menu, click the switch, and now the lights are back on. And if we open the materials factory and we turn on one of the recipes, we can see that the materials factory has power again. As a rather important side note, if you come to the switch and turn off the power, it will not turn off the power on the power station, or if you connect it to a diesel power plant, it will not turn off the diesel power plant. So if you are low on resources to burn for power, you still have to come to either your power station or power plant, open its menu, and turn off the recipe that is producing the power just to save your resources.